If you want to engage and inform your audience on LinkedIn, all while building trusted relationships, it's time for you to start a LinkedIn newsletter for your business. The best part is, it's not hard to get one off the ground. A LinkedIn newsletter is LinkedIn's version of an email newsletter. Basically, just a series of articles that are all grouped together under the banner of a single theme. You can have up to 5 newsletters at a time on LinkedIn, although I'd recommend starting with just one and seeing what happens. Your newsletter is a place to share content that shows off your industry expertise, whether you write about the latest news, create tutorials, or offer advice. This feature helps you reach a wider audience. I mean, just think about how LinkedIn works. When people you know repost, like, or comment on other people's posts or content, it shows up in your feed. If you like what you see and share it, it shows up in other people's feeds, and so on. So basically, an insightful newsletter can help you be more visible on LinkedIn and reach a larger audience, ultimately getting your brand in front of more eyes and building relationships. To get started, you want to make sure you meet all of the criteria for a newsletter. This is all from LinkedIn. First of all, you need to have at least 150 connections and/or followers. So you need to have an established audience. Second, you need to have recent experience posting original content on LinkedIn, like sharing photos, videos, or polls, not just resharing from other people. Finally, you have to be in good standing with LinkedIn when it comes to their community policies. If you have broken any platform rules in the past, they might not want to grant you newsletter access. So, don't post false information, don't be a bully, and don't be inappropriate. Just don't do offensive stuff. If you meet all the criteria, you're ready to actually create your newsletter. My advice before you launch your first edition, however, is to research your topic. What would your LinkedIn audience actually want from you? You can check out what your competitors are doing to figure out how you can do it better. Seek out trending topics on LinkedIn, and you can also see the newsletters other people subscribe to by looking at the interest section of their profile. Find people who are in your target audience and take a look at their subscriptions. Pair this information with the other customer insights you have from your content marketing efforts, and you should have plenty of information to shape your strategy. So, to make your first newsletter via your personal account, go to your homepage. At the top of your feed, you should see a button that says Write Article. When you click that, it'll take you to a publishing page. You can write individual articles on that page as well. To create a newsletter, though, click the Manage button and select Create a Newsletter. That will open up a dialog box where you can add your newsletter name, publishing frequency, description, and an image or logo. Make sure you choose a schedule that you know you can stick to. The key to a successful newsletter is consistency. From there, just hit the Done button. And now the directions for your company page. You have to be a super admin or content admin to create a newsletter for a company page. And fun fact, you can actually follow the directions I just gave you for a personal account, and you'll be prompted to choose who you're publishing as. Or you can go to your main company dashboard and choose the Create button. Then select Create a Newsletter and add all the info it asks for. If you have a newsletter and want to make a new one, you can just go to the Newsletters tab, which will show you all the newsletter editions you have, select Create New Edition, then Manage, then Create Newsletter. Again, add all the details so your newsletter is on brand. And now you can write articles to go into your newsletter. Of course, this step isn't a one and done type thing like the last two steps. You'll want to keep posting fresh content on that schedule you established during the setup process. That content should all fall under your chosen theme. That's the point of grouping all of those articles together into one newsletter. If you want to write about something that's kind of disconnected, you can publish it as an individual article, which you can easily do by selecting the Write Article option in the Post Composer box. Just make sure you have it set to publish as an individual article and not a newsletter in the top left corner. Whatever industry topic you choose, make sure it's something that's relevant to your audience that lends itself to a lot of content. If it's too niche, you'll write one article and then immediately realize you have nothing else to say about it, which is okay if you want to publish a one-off article, just not for newsletters. When you're ready to publish, you can hit the Next button in the Article Composer. You'll want to create a social post promoting the latest edition of your newsletter and either publish it immediately or schedule it for later, just like you would with any LinkedIn post. You can see any scheduled newsletter articles under the Manage tab, as well as published content and drafts. As you write articles for your newsletter, keep track of how successful they are at engaging users. Depending on what's working and what isn't, you can adjust your strategy to help it perform better, just like you would with any type of marketing campaign. You can view stats for each individual article by opening the article from the newsletter page and hitting View Stats. For overall newsletter stats, you can find those by directly going to the newsletter section of your analytics dashboard. And there you have it. That's your guide for creating a LinkedIn newsletter. Like I said earlier, it's pretty simple. When paired with a LinkedIn organic and paid strategy, you're sure to keep your audience engaged. If you're interested in learning more social media marketing tips or learning more about digital marketing in general, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell so you never miss our updates. In the meantime, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.